Hi, I'm Honey. In this video, I'm going to show you how I prep my watercolor paper for painting. So let's do this. In the past, I would omit this step and just encounter so many issues that could have been solved simply by just prepping my watercolor paper correctly. Once in a while, you can get away with not taping your paper down, but if you're doing anything water intensive like skies or landscapes in general, it's really important to tape your watercolor paper down so it doesn't buckle. The problem with a watercolor paper buckling is that the water and the paint flow to where it dips, and it flows away from where the paper is higher, creating unexpected and unintended results. So if you want more control with your water and your paint, it's really important to have the paper be as flat as possible. I'm going to list everything that I'm using in the description below. If you're using a watercolor block, you can skip this step because the watercolor block is already prepped, but if you're using a watercolor pad or sheet, then you definitely need to tape your watercolor paper down. If you're doing a watercolor painting that's not as water intensive, sometimes you can get away with not taping down your paper, but it's better to tape down your paper and not need it than not tape your watercolor paper and really need that tape to hold the watercolor paper down. I'm using 100% cotton watercolor paper by Arches. I typically use the 140-pound cold press type, and I've cut it to the size that I need. For the board, you can use any hard, rigid surface. I'm using a gator board that's slightly bigger than the paper that I have. If you don't have a board, you can also tape your paper to your table directly. The con with this is that you won't be able to tilt your board at all, but it will do in a pinch. To tape down the paper, you can use artist tape or painter's tape. I typically use a 1-inch wide tape, and that gives it a good 1/2-inch wide margin all around the sides. So let's start by taping the top of the paper, and just make sure to tape it as straight as possible. Just flatten that tape out, and then we're gonna tape the bottom part of the paper and just do the same thing. And then we're gonna do the left side of the paper. And then do the right side. And just make sure the paper is flat and everything's even. And that's it. If you like this video, make sure you subscribe to my channel so you can get updated when new videos come out. Thank you so much for watching.